This, what you see, is a 180 volts, 1.5 horsepower, permanent magnet DC motor that is usually used in treadmills. We can see two brush slots similar to many other DC motors. Now, if we open up the brush slots on both the sides, we can see how big the brushes are when compared to our common DC motors. The brushes power the motor armature that triggers the rotational movement of the motor. Now, I am going to use this 12 volts, 42 ampere hour battery pack to test it at just 12 volts. Therefore, we can now proceed further. Now guys, I have to tell you something really important. This piece that I took off from the flywheel, it is going to be the coupler of the two big DC motors. So this is a piece from one of the motor. So it is going to get connected to that easily without any problem. But the other DC motor, this is not the part of it. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to drill a hole through it and create a thread and also drill a hole through the shaft of that motor and pass the screw through the shaft of the motor as well, so that this piece gets strongly connected to the shaft of the motor, because otherwise when the machine is going to be loaded, in that case, if there is no thread and the shaft is just passing through it like this, it is going to slide over it under pressure. Let's get on to it. Now, I have successfully connected the two motors together mechanically, but there are still two very important pointers that I have to keep in mind. The first one is the difference between the RPMs of the two DC motors. That should be as minimum as possible. The second one is that before connecting the two DC motors together electrically, we will have to find out the direction of rotation of each motor. That should be same. The direction of rotation was clockwise. Therefore, we can now connect positive to positive and negative to negative. So here I'm 3D printing some parts for the machine. It's time to install them. Now guys, I will be using this 60 volts 2.7 amperes e-bike charger as power supply to run this giant DC motor, which is only 1/3 of the rated voltage required by my DC motor. Since I still do not have the fully rated power supply for this machine, I will have to make it in another video. Whoa. So here, as you can see, that this power supply is not powerful enough to start the motor on its own. Now this, what you see, is a 50 to 65 volts DC 41,000 microfarad electrolytic capacitor, which I will be using to boost up the amperes of my power supply, positive to positive and negative to negative. Next, one wire which is positive will be connected to the DC motor, while the other wire will remain disconnected, and it will be connected only after our capacitor has been fully charged. It is quite amazing how adding a simple capacitor can boost up the starting current just enough to give it a push and get it started. Smooth, right? For measuring the starting current, I'm going to use this Kiwetz clamp meter, which is already set at 60 amperes DC current measurement mode. So I'm going to set it to maximum so that whatever the variation is for the starting currents, it is only going to show the maximum 2.84 amperes, which is around 180 watts because I'm again feeding it with only 60 volts. So moving on to the specifications and applications of this new giant DC motor, I have used two big trademill motors with an RPM rating of 4000 to 4500 RPM. Next, I have chosen the trademill motors because they are permanent magnet DC motors that provide a very high starting and running torque, which is much more than that of an induction motor. So higher efficiency and more power to weight ratio. Next, if I go for the power rating of this new machine, it is more than 2 kilowatts, 2000 watts. And to be specific, it is 2250 watts, which is enough for testing my car alternators at their full power output, because when the car alternators are loaded, they draw a huge amount of current and they get very difficult to drive. So that's the main reason because of which I have designed this machine. And for the car alternators, I have always been thinking on making a big machine that is able to drive them. So here is the machine now, and in the coming videos you will see my alternator being driven by it and also tested for their loads. And now there is one more important thing. The RPM required by a car alternator is 2000, which is during idle condition, but for their full output, the RPM goes a little more than that. It is around 4000 or 5000 RPM for their maximum efficiency. Even though it goes to a max of around 15000, but their maximum output efficiency is at around 4000 to 5000 RPM. So this machine is going to be perfect for that. Next, there are other applications as well. Like if you want to make an electric car, you can use this kind of big DC motor. Plus, if you want to make a forklift or a normal lifting machine, this is going to be a perfect choice. And some other projects like your drift bike or go-karts. Now for the demonstration, I've only used 60 volts power supply, although it is rated at 180 volts. So obviously the performance that I've shown is quite low since I do not have the fully rated power supply. I will have to make it in one of my upcoming videos. Now for your project related queries, I would request you people to ask your questions in the comment section as early as possible, just after the video has been published. because after a day or two, I get really busy with my another upcoming project. And it gets really difficult for me to reply to you people then. I will still make time, but it might be delayed.